The Lifespan Trials are an initiative of Black Dog Institute, who received funding from the Paul Ramsay Foundation with a specific purpose of looking at the best evidence-based approach, an integrated suicide prevention approach. That approach looks at 9 strategies that look at health, education, frontline workers, looking at data, looking at safe and supportive ways of talking about suicide in our community, to each other and in the media. It looks at how we build community capacity to have those conversations, safe conversations, and about where to go to get help. Central Coast has been rolling out that trial of Lifespan for 2.5 years, from July 2017 to December 2019.
So we meet here today at Wombril Surf Club, and we're coming together in community. We heard from a number of people who've been actively involved in the Lifespan trial site here on the Central Coast.
As part of our research, we're looking at what is it that underpins Lifespan and what is it that makes it work. And we think that there are a couple of key things. First is that really effective local coordination and leadership. And secondly, that very effective alliance amongst different organisations within the Central Coast. So that's what really, I think, makes my heart sing, is actually seeing people who really care about suicide prevention coming together and supporting each other.
Everything today in that wrap-up resonated with me, yeah. But what it gave me was a lot of hope for where we're going as Central Coast towards the prevention of suicide. There's a lot of good people out there working on some critical areas, and I believe there's great hope.
The most significant thing that we've seen come out of Lifespan is the collaboration between different organisations. We've been able to work with organisations on the coast such as the Bendigo Bank, Central Coast Council, the Northern Settlement Services, Lifeline, Health. All of these organisations wouldn't normally get together to talk about something like this. So it's been exciting to see the different perspectives on how different groups in our communities see suicide prevention.
So many things here worked well, and so we're keen to learn from what worked well here and to emulate some of those things in Canberra. We've learned from the effective collaboration and coordination that's happened here in the Central Coast. The Suicide Prevention Alliance has obviously been a very successful opportunity for people to work together.
The most significant thing is the community connections. It is coming together. No one organisation, no one person has the answer. But you know, by working together, we can share and learn together, and that for me has been one of the critical parts of the Lifespan here on the Central Coast.
Being part of a coordinated approach where we are trying to help students, but people are out there helping their parents, helping their siblings, so that the whole community is really wrapped up in this one initiative to be able to affect everybody in the community at once.
Starting that information and that kind of ability to be able to sit in that space of talking about emotions and recognising emotions and what's happening for people is really important, because I think then hopefully that can build that knowledge as people do get older. So I think starting with young people and having that and then being able to have those community conversations.
One of the things that has happened with Lifespan is a really strong engagement with people who have a lived experience of suicide.
Being part of Lifespan is literally being a part of the solution. You know, it's giving you the opportunity to be at the forefront of change, rather than just to sort of sit there and say, oh look, we need to do this, we need to do this. Coming out to events, being involved, we're literally part of the solution.
There's a more of a holistic approach to dealing with this in the community, and that there is actually opportunities for people in the street who aren't medical professionals, who aren't in the sector, to actually get involved and make a difference. I think that's really important, that empowerment of the general community is really the most critical thing about that.
It's just really positive to know that there's a lot of will to continue the work for suicide prevention past the end of the Lifespan trial, and that's obviously going to continue to grow.
What I think will emerge even more over the next couple of years is really that local identity and ownership, and seeing suicide prevention as something that the Central Coast really strives in and has a strength in, and this is this is a great community, this is a strong community, this is a confident community.
Some of the actions we want people to move forward with are, if you want to become involved with the Suicide Prevention Central Coast Alliance, we'd love to have you on board. Become a YAM helper. Youth Aware of Mental Health needs helpers to go into our schools to help the instructors. Go online and do our free QPR, question, persuade, refer training. That gives you the skills, the knowledge, and the sensitivity to ask questions and know when someone is struggling, where to go.
I believe we've started something wonderful. I believe as a community, we can grow that and we can really make an impact into the prevention of suicide here on the Central Coast.